Hello, guys. It's me, Hiccup Haddock. Happy New Year for those of you who didn't watch the stream last night. It is now 2020. I start back school on January 6th. The nice thing is my schedule permits me to be more open than before, which means I probably will have more time to do videos, possibly. I'm not making any promises. As well, I have a 8 a.m. to 11 o'clock class on Wednesday, and then I'm at school until 9 o'clock at night, as I have a 6 to 9 class. So I have several hours in between that 8 a.m. class and that 6 p.m. class. As a lot of you have asked me to continue the comic, I'll continue the comic. It's not going to be at the same level as what the comic originally is and that you've been seeing. I don't have as much skill for that, but the comic will be continuing because enough people have aggravated me into doing it. Not that it bothers me much. I'm actually up to the challenge of continuing the second comic and seeing where I want to take it. It is not originally my comic. It is Jackie Bunny's, but I'm gonna continue it to where I believe it was gonna go. But thank you guys so much for the support over the year. I've pretty much almost got up to 10,000 subscribers. That is going to be a milestone achievement, and I'm going to have to do a video for that. Probably a stream, maybe. It depends on what you guys would want. But anyways, guys, I'm not going to ramble much more for this part. I'm gonna let you get into the video, and this is part 5, or where the comic was originally going to be discontinued by the original creator. So I hope you all enjoy, and I'll see you at the end credits.
Guys!
Oh no, he hurt us.
Why the hell did you scream that loud, Lyra?
Why? Because Dipper had to tell me the most awkward things ever!
Now that I'm here, could you tell me what the hell was so important that you had to yell and disturb me? Could you now tell me what you meant by now this? That was so loud that you had to wake me up? It has to be something special when it's so awkward.
Oh, yeah? You should definitely know. Well, Dipper asked for a little favor. Oh, gosh. Now I'm gonna be in for it. So what do you say?
I don't know. To be honest, Dipper, are you actually serious?
Yes. I'm sorry. I can't help it.
Okay.
Okay, that's all?
I'm surprised, Pine Tree. Your favor is pretty disgusting, don't you think? I didn't expect you to talk like that. But there is something in your eyes that I just can't stand when you're talking like that. Can't figure out what it is, though. By the way, what are you doing here, Lyra? You're supposed to be building my portal.
Your portal? I'm only building this portal for Dipper. You know that, right? I'm warning you. If you accept his favor, I'll break every bone in your body.
Very interesting. You can try it if you'd like. To be honest, I have to think about your favor now. No more lessons for today, Pine Tree.
Yeah, I'm not in the mood either. Let's head back to the cave. So, Bill, you said that when we're done having lessons, you'll change me back into a human? Is it time yet?
Not until you've wished for it. You really want to change back now?
Yes. Clues are pretty useless.
Alright, you asked for it. As you wish. Even though changing in the middle of a stream isn't the smartest idea.
Oh, fingers, I've missed them so much.
Wait a sec. Why am I naked? Where are my clothes? My body? Something isn't right. I remember my body. This is not my body. What did you do to me, Bill?
Changed you back? Like you asked? Waste my precious energy for you again? I told you, once you've discovered your true self, you will never go back to the way you were before. You're no longer bound to a 12-year-old boy's form. Now you're an adult, like it should be. And of course, your clothes disappeared. I can try and get you new ones, but maybe tomorrow. I'm too tired.
What?! I'm an adult. Ow! How is that? And do you really expect me to walk the rest of the way with only a bush to cover myself?
Yep, pretty much.
God, Bill, you can be such an asshole sometimes. It's gonna be so cold tonight. What do you want me to do, freeze?
I mean... Was your choice to change back. Not my problem now.
Mabel's up to now. Maybe she also has a big thunderstorm outside. Meanwhile, in Gravity Falls. Dear Dipper, I don't know where you are, but I hope you're doing fine. You're not gonna believe this, but right after I returned to the shack, me and Seuss discovered that Grunkle Stan had a portal. And guess who just came through it? Grunkle Stan has a twin brother, and he's the one who wrote those dumb journals you love so much. You always said you wanted to meet the author, and now you're missing him. He's staying here now, and does a lot of weird monster stuff. Anyway, he and Grunkle Stan can't really get along with each other right now. And I miss him. I'll write you every day until you come back. Grunkle Stan thinks you're dead, but I don't believe him. Love, Mabel. You gotta wear on. You don't.
feel so lonely. Where are you, Dipper? When will you come back? I shouldn't have run away. It's all my fault.
Where are you going now? Stargazing.
Yeah, quite brilliant tonight.
Don't even try bringing another monster back into the shack again. Can't you just act normal for once, Poindexter? Ever since you came through the portal, everything's been screwed up. Dipper's still gone, and because of that, the girl's spirits are down. And on top of that, and just how do I tell their parents?
I guess he's right. It's all my fault. I feel terrible. I know. You obviously won't respond. You've never responded after all those years. Nor while I was gone. I'm sorry that I couldn't protect your son. I promise.
What is that?
I swear I saw a light around here somewhere.
Did someone call my name? It's been a long time, Stanford.
Orion, my Lord of Light and Hope. I can't believe it. After all these years, while I was trapped inside the portal, and even now after my return, I attempted to contact you, but I never got any answer until now. Please, forgive me for being such a fool. I should have never struck that deal with Bill. And now, Dipper is missing, and we can't even find him. Please, have mercy on me. I wish I could help. I'm just so sorry. I just don't think he's alive anymore. I failed. It's all my fault.
That is enough. This is quite unlike me, my friend. Let the past remain in the past. For now, we have more important matters at hand, such as the welfare of the future. I know where my son is, and he's fine. You're not to blame for anything.
Phew. Well, I'm glad to hear that. So where is he?
He is trapped in a false dimension, created by a portal that was made by your government.
Oh.
And he is accompanied by Bill Cipher, who plans to kill us all once he returns.
Perhaps I should switch to human form, so that we're both on the same level. Well, your government could never create a false dimension like that without help. We had a great plan, my daughter and I. We provided mental instructions to your people, told them about Bill, and how to build a weapon against him. Unfortunately, the mission soured, but Lyra was able to sneak in and control the situation. The struggle between Bill and I would cause much destruction, so I chose to banish him to the safe world. Well, it seems that Dipper has accidentally stumbled into that world. We need another portal, though, which he can escape. Well, Bill remains trapped. That's where we need your help. Though, we can't build the portal ourselves with our instructions. I know that you can.
I'm flattered, but you know I've spent many years on a portal. It's impossible to build one in such short notice.
Not to worry. My daughter will help you. Once she has gathered the special materials, you will be able to construct it in no time. There is more. Do you remember my dear partner, Azerotrine? Well, I will share my true intentions for contacting her. She is no ordinary friend. She is as old as time and has always been at my side. She is my godson, my third eye. When danger is near, Ultramarine warns me. And should I need help, she gives me advice. But now, it is you who possesses the most important task. Ultramarine and I are not merely friends. We are bound together. 'Tis our destiny. Let me show you. This magical chain binds us together forever. But she is not having a second chance. We have to respect each other. And this is her duty to the whole life of the world. However, we both decided that it is time to turn the corner. Since I am not my girl at the moment, you have to save my son. You must save the world. I want you to send me. Take this chain. Ultimately, will be bound to you. With her guidance, you will not have to worry about anything.
Wait! Me?
She's quite excited to announce something that's been in time to come. In return, you will gain her wisdom.
But I failed you once already. Do you really think I could do it? This is like taking a goddess into my life.
By the way, what are you doing here? You're supposed to be building the... What? I'm an adult! How is that? And do you really expect me to walk the rest of the way with only a bush to cover myself? I know what the rest of y'all thinking. I know. Leave the bush alone and let's go. Don't lie to me, ladies and gentlemen. Do not lie.
Lyra, I just feel so stressed.
It won't go away. It's horrible. Listen to me, I know what your problem is. Come on, think about it. Springtime, you're nearly an adult. You know, time to mate with some does, making fawns and such stuff. You'll feel a lot better after that, believe me.
Mating? What do you mean?
You're shitting me, right? Are you kidding? That's nature, you dork!
It's the same every spring. Does just wait. Until a nice, strong, handsome buck crosses their way to, well... get pregnant. But mostly they are just pervs and idiots. Maybe enough for ordinary deer, but not for me.
What?
I will never do that. That's gross. And I don't want to have children. You're supposed to make children. That's your job. Spreading your genes all around the world, Dipper. Uh-uh, not for me. No thanks. Gah! You make me so crazy sometimes, Dipper. You men are all the same. We have to do our job, but you can do whatever the hell you want. There are natural rules. I mean, you just meet some does, and you can decide which one you'll pick. And we should be proud. I just have to walk through the forest. And when I turn around, there is a bunch of stupid bucks. They look so stupid, longing for, you know, with their stupid long tongue. Now I know what you meant. Huh? What? No! Dipper, not what I meant! Dipper, not what I meant! Oh, now I want a mate! No! Get that thing out of your head! It's not a doe! It's just... No!
You're talking about me, huh? Heard you want a mate with me?
Yes, Lyra told me it's important. No! Not what I meant, Dipper! Not what I meant!
Just to clarify, of course, you won't be on top.
Count me in. No! You won't! You won't! Bill, stop! Don't you dare! He is my brother!
Let's go somewhere else. I want some privacy.
Thank you all for the support over the last 4 years on this project. And I look forward to continuing it in the next couple of months. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed that extra bonus comic. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So long.